Hi, this is Jeremy King. I'm a senior product manager on the Adobe Analytics Cloud team. I'd like to take some time to introduce you to the new Adobe Analytics Connector in Power BI. This was developed in partnership with Microsoft and allows you to directly load your Adobe Analytics data into the Power BI experience. When you launch the connector, you'll authenticate using your Adobe ID. You'll be presented with this navigator that'll show you all the available report suites you have access to. When you break down a report suite, you'll be able to select the individual items within that report suite, the dimensions and metrics, everything you need to create the requests that you want to use to drive and build out your reporting. Let's go ahead and build a request. I'm going to build a request starting with dimension of operating system type. And we'll go ahead and find a measure of visitors. And for my report suite, I'm going to change the start reporting range to actually fall in April. I'm going to update the end reporting range as well. And apply that additional option. You could also choose to apply a segment to your request or choose top items to have it only return so many items back for that dimension. In my example, I'm going to go ahead and update the top to be 6 and only pull back the first 6 items. Once you've built the request the way that you want and you want to save it into your Power BI project, go ahead and hit load. Now we've successfully loaded a report from Adobe Analytics into our Power BI project, but now is where the fun starts. So I can go over here and find the We Retail data set table that just got loaded. I'm gonna go ahead and rename it so I can keep track of which data set this was. And let's go ahead and inspect the items inside. So we're gonna click on operating systems for the dimension element and visitors for the metric or the measure. Notice that the table that Power BI selected to represent the data shows the visitors metric, and the visitors metric isn't quite the format I was looking for. So why don't we go ahead and change that? I can select the visitors metric, go to the modeling tab, we'll keep the separator and we'll get rid of the decimal places. You'll notice that it will update the visualization as well as the actual data set that I have inside of the Power BI project. And then in terms of the visualization, maybe I don't want to represent this as a table. Why don't we switch it to a pie chart? Now, you may have noticed a few other data set tables already loaded in the right-hand side. If I switch over to page 2 of this report, you'll see a few other visualizations I went ahead and pre-built just to show you what's possible. Now, this isn't where you end. You also have the option of publishing the data sets that you've created and formatted, as well as the report that you generate, to the Power BI online service. A service you'll use to share this reporting out to others across your organization. So I'm going to go ahead and select my workspace and let it publish to the online service. And it's done. So let's go ahead and look at that experience. Now I've successfully published my data from Adobe Analytics into the Power BI desktop, reformatted those data sets to look like how I want represented for the reporting I need to create, created reports, and then published both the data sets and the reports I created in the desktop application to the online service. Now I have the option of taking these tiles that are in the reports and pinning them to dashboards, and then sharing those dashboards along with the reports and dataset assets with others across my organization. I hope you look forward to exploring this integration further.